Dalgona candy is very much like honeycomb, just that it doesn't have honey in it. And in this video, we are going to see how to make use of this Dalgona and make delicious Dalgona ice cream. Let's get started. Take a small karchi or a very small kadhai and put 2 tablespoon sugar. Keep the flame low and let the sugar melt. If you use a very big utensil to make this small quantity of dalgona, then there is a possibility that you would end up burning it. Once the sugar melts, add soda. So I'm adding 1/4 teaspoon baking soda or khane wala soda. You can also use plain Eno, I mean not the flavored one, the one which comes in blue packet. Continuously stir this mixture and put it on a greased plate. So I've applied some oil to this steel plate. Make sure your dalgona doesn't burn, and after it cools down, it will come off very easily like this. It's so light and airy. Look at the texture. So it's a honeycomb candy without honey. So now what we're going to do is, using a balan or rolling pin, just gently tap, because if you apply a lot of force, you will get very small pieces or powder of this dalgona, but we want some chunks. Our dalgona is ready. Put it in a bowl and keep it aside. Now in another pan or kadhai, put 3.5 tablespoon all-purpose flour or maida. Roast it for 2 to 3 minutes between low to medium flame. Make sure you keep mixing it so that it doesn't burn. We are doing this in order to remove the raw smell or the raw taste which you might get if you directly use maida. Now in another pan, heat 500 ml or 1/2 liter milk. I'm using buffalo milk because it's high in fat. Bring this to a boil. And after the roasted maida cools down, add some milk. The milk should also be at room temperature, even cold milk will do. We need to make a paste, because if you directly add the maida to the milk, you will get lumps and it would be very difficult to remove them. So make a paste. And after boiling the milk for 3 to 4 minutes, add 6 tablespoon sugar, 1 teaspoon instant coffee powder. Mix it well and then add the prepared paste. So make sure after adding this paste, you immediately stir the milk mixture. So these flours or maida or corn flour have been used in ice cream making for long as thickeners or thickening agents. So keep stirring this mixture and keep cooking it between low to medium flame and cook till it thickens like this. It would take around 10 to 15 minutes. It depends. It might take more or less for you depending on the flame. After it cools down, it would thicken so much. It would look like this, like a pudding. Well, that's perfect, because after you churn this in your mixer grinder, the texture and the color will change a lot. So for a minute or so, you need to churn it. Now look at the mixture. It's thick, but it's not that thick like a custard or a pudding. After putting the mixture in your plastic container, cover it with the lid and let it freeze for 6 to 8 hours, because after that we're going to again churn it. After the ice cream freezes for 6 to 8 hours, you need to churn it. So this will make sure that you do not get ice crystals in your ice cream. So this is one important step. So churn it for a minute or so. Now comes the best part. So we are going to put some of this mixture and then some dalgona candy pieces. So alternate layers of the ice cream mixture and dalgona candy. So when this dalgona candy sets in the ice cream, it slightly melts or gets mixed with the ice cream, and you would see some shading in your ice cream. So somewhere it would be crunchy, somewhere you would get the nice taste of caramel. some more dalgona candy on the top. Just keep aside a little for decoration at the end. Again, cover and let it freeze for 10 to 12 hours. Depends on the power of your refrigerator also. It might take less or more time. And after the ice cream is set well, you need to put it in regular water for a minute. If you want to demold the complete ice cream, then you need to follow this step, else you can just scoop it out. So after placing this tub in the water for a minute, pull the sides 5-6 times and then the ice cream would come out easily. You can see nice shading, and this shading is because of the dalgona. Decorate the ice cream with some melted chocolate. This is optional. You can put chocolate syrup or you can totally skip this step and only decorate this ice cream with dalgona candy pieces. You can also sprinkle a little more instant coffee powder if you want. So this ice cream turns out really nice. The crunch of dalgona candy and its caramel taste is just out of this world. Give this recipe a try and enjoy.